Hello class, today we're going to be talking about the first thing about forces, and that's going to be looking at three body diagrams. Now this is where the trig is going to come in handy. Last chapter you learned all about trigonometry and how much trigonometry with physics is painful. Now this is where it comes in handy. So we're going to look at this example and we're going to dissect it and we're going to take a look at how we're going to draw this so you can figure out a little later on the forces and how the forces interact with each other and how things can cancel out. Before bunks, sailors slept in hammocks strung between beams. Because the hammocks were suspended, you could be fairly level, and so it kept everybody kind of safe without hitting each other. So we've got a sailor resting in the hammock. The gravitational force on the hammock is 150 newtons. So the resting sailor also does another 850 newtons on the hammock itself. Supporting rope at one end is 780 newtons, and the other one is, again, 780 newtons, and 50 degrees counterclockwise or clockwise. So let's look at this. If we look at this, I gave it a little shortened value. So this is all background. You don't need to use this to solve anything, but it gives you an idea of what's happening. And this is important in physics because you got to know what's going on. And you need to know how to decipher these questions so you get the right equation and the right answer for the physics questions. So let's take a look. Let's draw this. So we've got a hammock. And we usually draw a little dot indicating, hey, this is where this is our object. And everything's going to act on this dot. Gravitational on the hammock is 150 newtons. So we're going to draw a little arrow down. God, that sucks. Down, strictly down. And this is going to be 150 newtons. And since it's going down, it's going to be negative. And now the sailor also exerts another 850 newtons. So on top of that, we got another 850 newtons. So we've got two forces going down, and you could add them like this, or you could just draw one arrow. My handwriting is bad. 4,000 newtons. Because 150 plus 850, that's going to be 1,000. And we're going to have two arrows going either side. And this is these ropes that are holding up supporting the hammock. And so both of them are 780 newtons. So this is going to be 780 newtons going one way and 780 going the other. Now I'm going to draw a dotted line. You don't have to be perfect with these drawings, guys. You just need to get an idea of what's happening. And we've got two angles here. This is going to, you notice that one supporting rope exerts a force of 780 at an angle of 50 degrees clockwise from vertical. So again, it's 50 degrees. So here's my 50 degrees going clockwise from vertical. Here's my vertical and going clockwise to the right. And this is 50 degrees. And this is also 50 degrees because I'm going counterclockwise or to the left. And so this is my drawing that we're looking for. This is how you do it. And this is how you label it. So again, let me redraw this. Hopefully I can draw a little better. There's my hammock and body. Hammock going down. And this is going to be 1,000 newtons, which is 150 for the hammock and 850 of the person. We got a line going up. And we have two ropes stretching away. They don't look equal angle, but they are. This is both 50 degrees. One clockwise and one the other counterclockwise. And this is the drawing that you need to do. And these are both 780 newtons. So for the drawing that you have, I want you to practice making these drawings, drawing the lines, drawing anything vertical or horizontal that you need, and putting everything together. And this will be the right answer for this example. If you have any questions, please see me during Scott time or after school. Thank you.